AI isn't just for research. It's a game changer for creativity. Whether you're brainstorming, storytelling, or just organizing your ideas, NotebookLM can help you think in ways you never have before. Let's dive in. Hey everyone, I'm Jamie, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to use Google's NotebookLM to take your creativity to the next level. I'll walk you through 7 powerful ways to generate new ideas, break through creative blocks, and get more out of your notes. Whether you're a writer, designer, or just someone looking to think more creatively, by the end of this video, you'll not only know how to use NotebookLM, but you'll also have actionable ways to use it for brainstorming, content creation, and even organizing your ideas better. Let's get started. Tip number 1 is about idea generation using NotebookLM, and I have a couple of different examples I want to show you quickly. I have some story notes, and these are just scattered notes on a Google Docs here about a possible story, and I also have a design project, kind of the same thing happening, and I want to use NotebookLM to help me generate ideas, to help me progress faster with getting this stuff done. So I'm going to go and create a new notebook now, and I'm going to connect my one document, not both of them at the same time, because they're different projects, and I'm going to go to Google Docs, and I'll pick the story notes here and hit insert. So it gives me the summation here, but what I'm after is having the conversation. So down here, I'm going to ask it a question. And notice, it's already suggested the question that I could go with, and this is another thing I like about NotebookLM. Based on the notes that I gave it right here, it's going to be pulling out questions. So it might pull out questions I don't even know I'm looking for. But in this case, what are some unexpected plot twists based on my notes? So if I send this away, you're going to see it will create a list of potential ideas of plot twist here. So as I go down the list, you'll notice that they give a lot of different ones. So here's the one at the bottom, discovery of the horrifying truth about the Watcher's existence at the observatory could be something completely unforeseen. And it will go into detail, and then it also gives me where it's pulling maybe this possible idea out of. Over here, you can see in the notes. But let's go further and ask it another question now. I'm going to just close that one and ask this. How could Eli's personal past tie into the Watcher's mystery? So that's a pretty specific question I'm asking to get ideas. So let's see how many ideas will give me for that. All right, another list it gives me here. Eli's skills as a journalist are rooted in the past encounter. The predicted event is tied into Eli's past. So it starts to give me all these different ideas. So you can see if you loosely put your ideas like I did on a piece of paper, how it can start generating ideas for story writing. But let's say if it's a design project. I just switched over to a new notebook that I created for my design project here. And I just wanted to point out with the differences. So the first one was about writing a story. This is about design. I uploaded my notes and I can start having that conversation. So what are some unique layout ideas for the homepage? I'm looking for a web page design, and it's going to go based on my notes. It's going to start giving me ideas. So when I can generate ideas this quickly, and I still have to go through them all, I'm not going to believe it at first hand, but you're going to see you're going to get so many ideas so quickly that your creativity will just explode. Audio stimulation is tip number 2. Now, this is the thing that's made NotebookLM so popular this year, and I'll give a brief example here. So let's say I've taken all this material that I've collected on traveling to Japan, from YouTube videos to websites to PDFs. Now, with a simple click, I turned it into a podcast.
It's sustainable tourism tips.
Wow.
That I can listen to. But the great thing is I can download this podcast as well. So if I go here and click download, I can go put this on a different device. And I don't know about you, but my creativity starts getting better when I can step away from my computer. So if I can take all this information and go ahead and put it, be listening from my phone and just consuming it outside on a walk or even driving, I just find this enhances the way I think. And then when I get back to my computer, everything seems a little bit more clear. And the other thing is that you can go into interactive mode here. And just like before about asking questions, I can do this by using the audio feature of this multimodal. So if I hit play.
It's for about 2 weeks.
Oh, that's awesome.
I can click join.
Back to
it's
our
like
listener.
Putting up my
What's
hand.
Up?
And I'm going to ask, have you ever been to Japan before?
Yes, I have.
One time so far.
It was long enough to get a taste of things.
Oh, a little teaser.
So that was me asking a question to them, and they gave me the answer. And I was surprised that they said yes, that they have been to Japan before. So all these different methods of using this audio stimulation to enhance your creativity. So we've seen how listening to AI-generated audio summaries can spark new ideas and enhance creativity. But what if you could take it one step further, transforming your spoken ideas into visually compelling videos? That's where Filmora's AI-powered storytelling tools come in. With just a few clicks, Filmora can turn your podcast narration or any audio content into an engaging video, complete with dynamic visuals, animations, and seamless transitions. Let me show you how quickly you can get started with this. Simply drag and drop your audio into Filmora, and its AI will analyze the content, matching with high-quality visuals, motion graphics, and even auto-generated captions. No need for hours of video editing. Filmora handles it all for you. With that simple drag and drop and a few clicks, it created 5 different videos for me from that one audio file I uploaded. With each of these files, you can see that they're all subtitled.
It offers much more than sushi.
And all the visuals that have been added in through the AI. Whether you're a podcaster looking to reach a wider audience, a content creator repurposing audio, or someone who wants to bring their stories to life visually, Filmora makes it easy. Ready to take your storytelling to the next level? Try Filmora today. I've added a link in the description. Turn your words into captivating visual experiences in just minutes. Number 3 is brainstorming in NotebookLM. So I already have a notebook opened here. I'm going to add a source now. But this time, when I add a source, I'm just going to go and paste some text in. And in this example, let's say I have a number of different, a list of different blog ideas or YouTube videos, and I'm just going to go and insert this in. I want NotebookLM to help me get organized and even get more ideas from this. So my first question to all of this list is going to be this one. It's going to be, which of these topics are best suited for beginner-friendly tutorials? So I'm going to go ahead and send that off. What I'd really like to know out of this list, which of these will be best suited for beginner-friendly tutorials? So I'm going to send that. And right away, it will start analyzing that list and kind of gives me ideas of where to start from. But maybe I want to get organized a little differently and sort them like this. Topics, maybe categories, AI tools, Microsoft Office, content creation, productivity. Again, all that brainstorming that you've done, now you can use NotebookLM to help you get everything organized and get more ideas out of it. To make your brainstorming even more powerful, try collaborating with others. Just go up to your share settings, add the people that you'd like to work with, and then give them the type of access that you would like. Number 4 is creating content. You can use NotebookLM to help you with this. I've already showed you the one example up here with creating a podcast and downloading it, but if you go back a step and just think even simpler, how you can use this to create summaries, briefings, or even help you prepare for a slideshow. So here's a quick example. If I just go ahead and ask it, and I only have the one PDF in here, summarize this research paper into key findings and insights, it will quickly handle any of this. Now, what I like about with NotebookLM, they have these shortcuts you can do as well. So you'll notice that we have briefing doc here. If I go ahead and click it, and notice as it generates over here, and I'm just going to open this up when I click on it again. At any time when they go over there, you can convert it to a source as well. So if I click convert to source, notice it's added to my list here. Now with any of these, I'm going to close this up. I have a few different options. Do you want a study guide? Do you want a timeline or FAQ? These are all great types of content you can create. So here's another example. I'm just going to go here and ask it to create a presentation briefing summarizing the research and have slide numbers in it. I'm going to send this off. Now, based on the PDFs that we have or this check sources, notice I have slide 1. They're giving me a title idea, subtitle, source, and they have it broken down. Now I can go ahead and take this information out of here and put it into whatever slideshow I'm using to create. If you want to make things simpler for maybe a different audience you're showing it, we could go do something like this. Reword this for a general audience who isn't familiar with EVs. Now they've made it much simpler to understand if you need to share this with that type of audience. Lastly, maybe I ask it to create something for Twitter, like this. Condense this into 3 points for a Twitter thread. Then notice how it's broken down with the 1 of 3, 2 of 3, 3 of 3. so many different ways that you can use NotebookLM to help you create content. Number 5 is using NotebookLM to help you with writer's block. Now, here's an example. I have this opening scene here, and it ends at this point here. You can see at the bottom, you shouldn't be out there alone, Lena. This is called the silent passenger. I'm going to say, I don't know how to finish this, and I need some help with NotebookLM. I already have the notebook set up here and the Google Docs in it. I'm just going to go ahead and ask it this. Give me 3 new ways to continue this story from where I left off. So if I go and send this, you're going to see right away, it gives me some ideas. Now the voice in the radio becomes more intense and specific, a little bit more information. Lena experiences more tangible and unsettling occurrences that suggest a real presence. And the last one here, despite the isolation, an unexpected external element intervenes. Now, if you like this, use that save note like I did before, and you can add it as a source. Each time I come back and I could do it again and ask the same question, it might give me 3 different ideas as well. But definitely take advantage of this with creativity and help you with your writer's block. Number 6, I want to show you how deep understanding is showcased in NotebookLM. Here's my example. I have a few different long form blog formats. I want to show you how NotebookLM can extract, then analyze, then restructure key insights so you can repurpose this materials for other social media. So let's give this a try. So how can I get to the deep understanding of these 3 articles? Will I have them selected? Well, if I just go ahead and ask the key themes from these blog posts to be summarized, right away, I can quickly scan through this. And like always, it's going to be cited to where it's pulling the information. So at this point, I can just go and give it a quick skim and find that information. But you can continue on with this by saying something like this. Maybe you want to turn these into social media posts, but I want them short, engaging as well. Now we started from the long form content here. We got our summation up top, and just within a couple of questions, we have it now down to the short social media post here, even with the hashtags with it. Number 7 is about using NotebookLM to find unexpected connections and idea fusion. This is what I mean by this. So I have 2 different papers, and I was random. I downloaded them. I put them into NotebookLM. I don't really understand what these are about. I didn't really read them. But as I go through, I'm going to show you what I asked. I said, what connections exist between these 2 topics? And it went through and said, there's no direct connection, but it went through and they said they can consider potential indirect connections based on broader scientific understanding. And then it went in and explained that right here through all this information. So I'm starting to see if I uploaded 2 different papers and if I'm doing research on something, looking for that connection where maybe I thought it didn't exist, this could be a good start. Then I asked, how could I merge these ideas into something new? Again, it's going to pull out, and everything's being pulled out from this information. Everything is cited where it's going to be basing it on. So I'm kind of doing research between these 2 different documents here. And it's giving me this information. Again, I'm not an expert on these papers, but I'm just showing you what you could ask it. And then at the end, generate a project concept that fuses both of these subjects. So here's the project concept that fuses the 2 subjects, and it goes through and gives me all these different details of it. So I'd like you to try some different papers where maybe you thought there was no connection and using NotebookLM to find it, and then again, getting your creativity going on those topics. So what do you think? Is NotebookLM something you could see yourself using to help getting your creativity going? Now, I know for myself, I really like using the writer's block one if I can't think what I want to write next, and just getting those ideas to get generated, and plus the audio one, downloading those files as an audio to be able to listen to and get away from the computer. I love it. So thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.